Before I got out of school and decided to be a musician, I felt like I needed to understand what it was like to have to really work for a living. Like most people have to work in this world. I bought a used van for $700 from my mom's ex-boyfriend from high school. It was a used car salesman. Sweet deal on a rusted out van with no windows. My friends used to call the kidnapper mobile. I drove north up to Canada, and I started looking for work as a farmhand up there. And I would go from town to town. I'll go from town to town, and I would go into the each little tiny town, and I'd go to like the corner store or the local pub. These are like all one street towns and scattered north of the kind of Great Lakes. And I would go and I would say, "Who's the local farmer in town?" And they'd send me out, and I would go meet with, and I'd show up at the farmer and say, "Hey, I'm wondering if you could use an extra hand on the farm." And they'd say, "No, thank you, not driving." And that went on for a few weeks. And then finally I got work. I got work at a farm in Cookstown, Ontario. Population 67.
Big town.
Yeah. It was a metropolis. And I showed up on this farm. I went up to the farmer there, and I said, "Hey, I heard in town that you might be looking for some work." And he said, "Oh, as a matter of fact, I am. How much experience do you have with cows?" I said, "I've seen a cow before." And he said, "Thanks, but no thanks. It's going to take me a week or two just to get you up on your feet around here. And it's just easier for me to do it myself, And I drove off. And I turned, and I got about a mile down the street. I'd been on the road for a while, and I failed at landing a job for a while. And I said, "Man, this is like a chance, I think." So I turned the van around and I drove back, and I walked into the barn, and the farmer turned around and he said, "You again?" And I said, "Yeah, I was wondering, well, just thinking maybe if you could put me up if you could put me up, I'll work for the first week for free. And then after that week, you can decide whether or not you want to hire me." He said, "I gotta be stupid to pass that up. I guess you're hired." And he said, "Come back tomorrow at 7 a.m. to start work." And he was being kind that first day because
he starts at 5.
No, I wish he started at 5. First milking is at 3 a.m.
Shit.
But I didn't know that when I joyously drove out of that driveway because I wanted to go there. I saw a pub in the one road, in the one intersection in the town called Fitz's. I walked into the pub and I sat down and I had a drink. I sat down at the drink and I noticed this thing happening while I was sitting there and I was having my beer. All the dudes that walked in, all the nasty, like burly, mean-looking guys that walked in, they all sat at the same table. They all sat at this round table. It was set back a little ways from the bar. And I noticed that they would sit down at the table and they would just kind of plant themselves down. The guys at the table would look up and they'd be like, and the waitress would come over and they'd put the beer down. They didn't have to order a beer, And I thought to myself, sitting at that bar looking So I tried to look as mean as I could. And I noticed that they were all drinking, mostly Canadians. And they were all drinking these Canadian cigarettes called Demariers. So I ordered most of Canadian and back to Demariers and tried to smoke without coughing. And fast forward a couple weeks, and I would finish a long day at the phone, and I would go to Fitzy's, and I would go and I would sit down at that table, and I would hang with those guys. And a waitress would come over, and she had my most of Canadian ready for me, and she put it down. And I try not to look really like excited that I was part of the table. I met some amazing characters at that table while I was there. And this is a song about one of those characters. This is a true story about one of those guys. He's a chucker that I met. And he was a guy that under normal circumstances, I don't think that I would have been friends with this man. Well, my name is Ray Thomas, a trucking off of here, and I'll spin you a tale if you lend me your ear. And you keep me supplied with a smoke and a beer. Well, I'm 65 now and I'm still on the road, doing locals up north in the snow and the cold. But at night it's back home where I'll drop off my load, and I'll go out to see my Makayla. And it's Fitzy's in town where us locals do dwell, and the booze treats you right, and it's all that they sell. And the girl in a skirt comes right over to me, and she serves me a beer, and she's all that I see. I'm a Makayla. Makayla, you're a vision to these eyes of mine, and you can talk to me any and every old time. You're the reason I'm still on this earth, can't you see? You're a goddess, a poet, a beauty to me. I killed a man once, back in 73. I was doing a job down in West Tennessee when a man fell asleep. He swerved into the oncoming lane. Well, they all told me that I wasn't to blame. Oh, and I turned to the bottle where I've been ever since, and I ain't coming back till I no longer glimpse that boy's body, crushed all the way into his backseat by my 18-wheel killer, my hands and my feet. And on a hard day, she knows and she gives me a smile, and I'll tell her a joke, and she'll laugh for a while, and she'll keep the beers coming to 2 or till 3, and I'll wrap myself up in my own fantasy with my Makayla. Makayla, reading my mind, it's okay to forget for a while what's behind, and you are gone one more day at a time. Day at a time. Well, my eldest son, Randy, he took off with a shout. And a shot crossed my jaw when he knocked me clean out. He stood up on his feet, the man I taught him to be. With my own swollen knuckles, like my dad did me. And my two girls, they live here in town. They each married a Jones boy, true love they have found, or at least they'll keep thinking till they hit the ground from a dream that grows old and faded. And my wife, well, she shuts her mouth. 'Cause I'm paying the rent, and I will beat her like hell, and that's where I'll be sent. For I've known all along since I was born where I'm bound to a place where I'll no longer hear the sweet sound of my killer. Hello, angel, you turn me around. You're the daughter, lover, and meaning I found. And you are not cursed by my Thomas bloodline. You don't like know me yet. Thank your God and thank by night, and it's studied by day, that she'll soon make her fortune. Don't come as a surprise that she takes on the world with invincible lies. Works now 3 years at Fitzy's. May all come to me. And a man who comes here we fill up the room, and we each get a turn at her service divine as we pour retribution one at a time by McKay. Kayla, you never will know the extent of your magic. To us, stand alone, and Kayla, I'm yours till the day that I die. But I know that your future is greater than I am. Greater than I am.